Wow, they've really made the gas clouds like darker green. That's turning our attention inland. Hello, my friend. Fucking hell. Did I hit an ammo depot? Look at his face, look at his goggles. Oh, he's sad now. He's dead.
Yeah, he's dead.
He's sad and he's dead. Like a zombie.
Would you be happy if you would be dead?
I don't know. I'm not sure if I'd be able to do emotions anymore.
But this is quite fun. For some reason, I'm really enjoying this.
Now you're stuck in the barbed wire. Cool.
No, I'm not.
Just showed you walking into barbed wire on my screen. What are you doing? Come on then. I'll take you all on.
What is this thing?
Mine's a spade. Oh, you've got the weird Tusken Raider Star Wars-y add-on thing.
What the fudge is it?
Tortilla? It looks like an ice cream scoop of some sort.
Yep, exactly.
It looks a bit wrong for a weapon. Yeah, it looks like an acorn on a twig.
Yep. Come on, who wants to be an acorn?
who wants some? Take me on, I've got an acorn on a stick.
Yep.
Yes. Okay. That put them on edge, look at them!
That blinding light! Yeah, have you seen it? It's really weird!
Ah, man.
Oh my god!
That was a good shot, but they only took 90% of his life!
Ammo, Mr. Flibble!
Mr. Flibble's very cross.
Worth a try.
We have almost won.
That was pretty cool. Denied. What is that? That's not what the moon looks like. What? What? That ship just flew in the sky! The ship is flying! Ooh! Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, train. Thanks a lot, train. You bastard. The power in these waters. Some weird fucking plane again. That was a good bearing to take. This is not... Fuck! I didn't bail early enough. And I'm swimming with the fishies. What is he doing? He's doing some sort of weird levitation thing. Parked. Lol. That was great. Oh, okay, that was a bit too close on reflection. Pull up. Can you hold still? What are you doing, mate? Smooth.
Come to England, they said. It's springtime, they said.
We need to redeploy immediately.
Immediately. Immediately, because that's what British people sound like. Immediately. You may be experiencing some death. Engine of the year. My lift is going. My lift is going, Dave.
Enemy over here.
That's kind of funny. Are you in? Oh, you're in the sea. Oh.
Yeah.
I don't know if you're gonna.
It might. Just skip swim.
Take a long time to swim.
I'm going towards you, so I'm really close to your boat.
I think so. Oh, I can see you in the water now. There's another friendly boat. Can you get on that one? Oh, no, he drove by. Can you do the, I need a ride command. Hold Q, request to the right, and then...
We have a dreadnought en route. But I'm really close to your boat. Yeah, hopefully you might nobody...
There's no seats.
No seats.
you're just in the water.
Three meters away.
Can you climb up onto the actual boat? Maybe you can.
No, I don't think so. It's too high up.
Is there no ladders?
I don't think so. I don't know.
I think some of these boats you can climb onto.
Dude, help! Wait for me. You're an asshole.
I'm watching you swim. Oh no, our boat's driving away. Yeah, I'd redeploy. a torpedo just skidded
just
past
blew
you.
Past my ear. Freaking hell, that was scary. Oh, I'm gonna try and go towards the land.
You're gonna swim all the way. That's gonna take you ages.
Don't worry. Okay,
I'll pick you up. I'll pick you.
Swimming. I feel like Dory now. Will I find Nemo?
Take a seat before I blow up. Yes.
Ah!
No. Woohoo. There's a plane over there.
You found me. Thank you.
Who keeps sniping me? Who's that? Qualtalus? Cool name, but god damn it.
Cursed in German. What the fuck?
Go for it. Scheiße.
Yeah, exactly.
Scheiße. Once the flame goes, I will charge. Yes! Oh, I speared him but got killed by someone high up. There's a lady in the archways on the high ledge in the church. I thought he was going to get into the trench that I was charging down, but he just stayed on the rim and looked down at me.
Okay.
There's these two guys on our team just pointing guns at each other, just like...
Can they point the guns? Ow! I can't jump! Dice, please! No keys.
Swedish Viking, goodbye, Swedish Viking.
Oh no!
Do you have a grenade? Chuck one down that trench. Come on, how many times have I hit you in the shoulder? Sneaky lady. Sneaky lady, come out from your hidey hole. I can see you. Oh gosh! Distracted by someone on top of the trench. You must be standing on a health pack! How are you doing this, you superhuman? She is standing on a health pack. There, okay, I've set her on fire. Take that. Thanks for the ammo. Fed up with trying to sniper, I set her on fire. She can deal with that.
I think you're a sexist, misogynist dinosaur.
Oh, are you a bad guy? Get fucked. Have some bullets. Yes, I destroyed a vehicle. Wow. Did I just blow up a C-class airship? Where was that? I don't even understand. Oh yeah, let's do it. Dude, shoot him. Shoot that guy. This is so funny. He's right in front of you, dude, on the airship. Shoot his face. Oh god. I missed. I'm not lined up. What vehicle got destroyed? Alright. Fuck you, airship. No. Hey, someone's left their motorcycle behind.
Join?
If you want. You can fire out of it.
I
am actually stuck, so I'm gonna get out. Oh, we're both support now.
Yeah.
Oh. There was no fire there. I just caught on fire from nothing. That's gotta be a bug.
Okay.
Oh no! Medic!
Oh god, it's only us on the server.
Oh.
Hi!
Who are we gonna? I'm black. What, yeah. Am I a different race or is my skin mucked up?
No, you're a different race.
Oh, okay, that's fine. As long as I'm not actually pure black, that's fine.
Yeah,
like Slender Man.
Oh, don't be so creepy.
Oh my god, there's a flying... Like, what the heck? There's a serious glitch on this map. Where am I?
Guys, you're not going after the freaking pigeon.
Yeah! Go for the pigeon, squad. Damn. I can only hope they walk over my bottle bombs. Oh, hold on, you're a medic. Watch out, though. Watch out!
Pick up the pigeon!
You got the pigeon? Oh my god!
Yeah!
Protect the pigeon holder.
Yeah, now.
Yes. Did it survive? No, it just fell out of the sky in front of me. Oh, it was so cute. It was so cute. How could you?
I've almost completed Battlefield 1. I say from the release date and all through the five different DLC add-on packs. I guess this is partly a bit of a review. It's you go into that room, you just catch on fire. You can get kills with the field guns. Planes can have fun. Here's a guy. Here's a guy having some aerial combat. So yeah, you can have fun as a plane on this map. Whoa.
Why?
Could it be for love?
We have lost objective action.
Oh! One bullet left in the gun! God damn.
You're injured, I can help! Wounds, I can fix them!
We have lost Objective Charlie. We have taken Objective Apples.
We took it after the
nice one. Oh my god, what? That was a bug! A guy teleported into the sky above my head as I was bayonet charging.
Ouch, someone shoot at me.
Someone
better than you. Ah! I picked up the pigeon!
Run!
I'm trying!
Hide!
Hi!
Oh!
Come on!
Someone upstairs of that house.
I found a roof terrace. I've gone through security and I found a roof terrace, which is what I wanted.
Only slightly raining, it's not too bad.
Мама говорила, колбасеры — это сила.
Пайфа ausgestattet.
I would like to welcome you on behalf of Lufthansa on board of our Airbus A300.
Compositor, composer, Cyprian Porumbescu.
And all the heads. I think they all have different expressions, they might all be different people.
Alice de Gasperi. Altiero Spinelli. There's three of them. There's three of them. Hello, Pisica. Hello, Pisica.
So I'm not sure, but I think that this is the paved area where everyone gathered and booed Ceausescu before he got thrown out of power.
Manifestare Populare din București.
And I think he stood up on that balcony. He stood up on that balcony and his face dropped when he realized the people didn't care anymore.
Bye! he didn't stand a chance, really, once he knew it. He's just folding his... is it the same on your screen as it is on mine? He's folding his arms, like, disapprovingly.
He's with his butt up in the air.
Oh, it's different on my screen. You noob. Oh, there's also a communist. Oh god, it's getting boring now.
You're from a country that never knew communism.
Yeah.
Sniper! Oh, yeah. He's far away. He's near the other bunker.
He's quite near me.
Yeah, I think you're there.
Mm-hmm.
He's down. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well.
I have no further use for you, old man.
He's dead.
Yeah.
We have taken objective apples.
Haha, yes. I killed two people. He's like, didn't see that one coming. How do you like activate a thing?
So I don't have enough money for a helicopter for some reason.
Well, they just left. Get a car. They just left, man.
Oh, actually, no, we can't get a car.
Great. Oh, we've been overtaken by a pickup truck.
I don't think it does it on this node, I think it might on different.
It's trying to kill you!
Dude, what's he doing?
There's an absolute- Oh, this is exactly what happened in Twister. Why is it like green laser beams and red laser beams?
Traces.
But they look so silly. Laser beam helicopter. No. There's a fox or something. There's a rabbit. There's a friggin' rabbit.
Who is that?
Now, what is crouch?
X.
What's this? Ah, I have not used this before. Got some. Got someone. Yes.
Instead, they have to go full reverse, and it's almost enough to make me go superstitious again and go, oh, you know, it's this stuff happens because of karma. Like, I wanted to vlog, and I just thought I couldn't vlog. I'm vlogging now, I guess. I don't know if I'll post this or not. But I guess I'm vlogging now. But I just thought, I can't self-express myself right now. There'll be, like, censors or internet police going around censoring jokes, and, like, we're gonna jail you for a fucking joke or, like, a tame-ass opinion.
I'd like to have some berries or milkshake. I just knew that I wanted to do this at some point.
What are these snipers doing here? This is the worst place for them to be. Ha! Huh. Whoa, that guy on fire prone was alive? He killed me.
Really?
He killed me just before he died. He's like crawling up the stairs on fire and he shot me with his pistol and then continued ascending, then died from the fire.
Oh my god.
So that's kind of horrific.
Oh.
Wait for death.
Whoa,
what a nice kill, oh my god. Bye bye, Santiana. Squad wiped! Okay, I don't know where this guy is you're talking about.
Yeah,
oh, there's someone over there. There he goes. Yeah. Bye. And he's got a friend.
Shit.
Oh no! Got him, got him.
Yes, thank you.
He's still got buddies though. Oh!
Just about a Star Wars film that's coming out that I'm not gonna watch. A lot of the games from LucasArts were based in the EU. Not that one. The Expanded Universe. Right, so there's a new Star Wars film coming out, like Solo. I don't know why they're making it. Anyway, it's another one of these things, and I don't like the direction they're going with it. It's terrible. I think social justice is too pervasive in cinemas right now. Saying about the new Solo film, we're gonna make Lando a pansexual character, and that was my thread, basically. That was me responding, just a casual, you know, I don't agree with this dumb direction Star Wars is taking. Also, I'm anti-SJW, so all this stuff is just the stuff I've been fighting for frigging years. So the SJW dogpiled it. I just get all these frigging notifications on my phone, like, what the fuck?
What a douche you are!
give me some health.
Oh yeah.
Thanks. Shit, don't get down.
Whoa. Ah!
Ouch. How the fuck?
I did not see them. You have an eagle eye. Oh! His helmet was too hard or something. This is the skin. Dark grey. Fuck!
But the hype train has blown up after the trailer got revealed. Takedown's guy with a samurai sword for some fucking reason. Maybe it is World War II. Now I'm thinking Vietnam, because we're in jungles and swamps, everything's colourful and green and forested. Sci-fi! And SWAT teams and modern combat and cartoonishness. With the guy doing the whispery takedown. And then there's something that I think would appease feminists who scream, "You're being ableist!" This can't be the direction they're going, can it?
And has quite a lot of ammo and is quite accurate, but doesn't do tons of damage. Very good for being accurate though.
We have taken objective.
Only got an assist for that. Look at this garish frigging tank. Oh my god, they both have the same skin. It's horrific.
Ironically, this meme that inspired me is talking about the very same thing that is why my account got locked. It's a meme of what looks like a mother throwing a baby off a cliff, and you think, why would you do that? Like the mother is meant to care for the baby, it's like the something important you should be caring for, but for some unknown reason you're throwing it off a cliff meme. Slightly political satire humour. So I'm starting to have enough with these authoritarian rules that some of the social networks are putting out. A law in the EU that apparently nobody noticed early enough to stop it.
Oh man! What is that guy firing at? What are you firing at, Chocolate? Come on, pick a target. What are you doing?
Having fun.
He's having way too much fun. Yeah, I must have destroyed a tank that was driving pie. Bye. Driving pie. The driving pie.
Driving pie.
60 life.
Got him. Oh, his horse is like parked on the beach.
Yeah. That's a heavy horse. And really low health. If someone shoots at me right now, I'm dead.
You'll get the auto heal in a few seconds.
Yeah.
You'll be alright.
I'm a strong, independent black woman.
Oh!
Hey,
don't have any of my old weapons. I reached near the Supreme Commander rank in the original game. Yeah, I think Battlefield 1 is definitely a better game than 2142 now. Just because of all the features they added just to make the gameplay way smoother. Oh, Jesus. Are they both men just eating themselves?
Stop!
Ah, it's Father Christmas. Do we have to read? And for my very special granddaughter. Wait, do I have to click to advance? I want you to have the sealed envelope. Okay, Santa. Does it have, like, candy? Does it have sweets inside? Oh, he threw it at me. Alright. What's that? That icon looks like horniness. It's wet for some reason. Okay. If you choose male, does a bone come up in a speech bubble? I've enclosed the deed to that place my pride and joy. Absolute unit farm. It's Marble Garden Zone! Can we, like, run down the hills really fast? Okay. Don't listen to her synthetic beef. Let's imagine that I'm gonna get 1,000 new bits of furniture. Compact design. Alright, can I move this? Oh, that's gonna be amazing. Can I move? I can move the window. I don't think that should be allowed.
Come here. Oh my god, this is a crazy chase.
Get out of here.
Yes.
Oh, okay, I need to repair this wing, I think.
Got him.
Nice. Oh, you
He's
did that.
Fresh.
Nice.
Yeah.
You see him?
Yes. Goodbye.
Really close to dying.
There's a guy with a machete behind you. What the fuck? Ah! Get up! Oh, not you. That's not an enemy. This is an enemy.
Oh my god. Why didn't I record that? I think I killed like 20 people.
There's more of them! Get out of here. Jesus. Get out of my house. Oh, there's like four of them downstairs.
I think I've killed seven.
Are you still alive?
Oh, yeah, no, not anymore, but oh my god, that was intense. That was intense, that
well,
was
I can record
intense.
My view of it, but I didn't see as much as you
and
did.
You didn't see as much as I did.
No way.
You have no idea, they were just coming in and they didn't know what was happening.
There's a YouTube channel called Forgotten Weapons, which is really interesting. They actually show off an actual puckle gun that they've got, like, he's got a room and he shows how you load it. It's really interesting. You should find that video on YouTube and watch it if you're interested in this era. These puckle guns really kind of wipe out anything close range to them, so now my carabiners have routed. God, stop going prone, you bastard. Go crouch. Yes, open that door. I wonder if I killed him, though. I've got to treat myself. I hope they can't hear me treating myself.
The other sound's probably not, but... probably more likely...
Oh, I killed him. Alright. Oh, has he got a friend? He's got a friend! Oh, I'm dead!
Oh,
he's killed by frantic. Yeah. Frantic tick 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 tock.
Play two for watching!
What the fuck was that?
No one would have believed in the last years of the 19th century that this world was being watched keenly and closely by intelligences greater than man's, and yet as mortal as his own. That as men busied themselves about their various concerns, they were scrutinized and studied, perhaps almost as narrowly as a man with a microscope might scrutinize the transient creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water.
We can no longer continue to make policy for ourselves, in our country, in our region, in our continent, on the basis of whatever support the Western world or France or the European Union can give us. It will not work. It has not worked, and it will not work.
The Ghanaian president, who is awesome as fuck, giving a speech with Macron, the French president, and he was going, like, our country doesn't need any of your fucking charity. Like, they sentenced him to pay an £800 fine instead of sending him to jail. Being the good boy that Dank is and rejecting a punishment which he shouldn't have been given for humour, and paying that amount and way more to charity, and rejecting the punishment and appealing it, I thought, oh, okay, well, he's not going to jail now, even though this is still a really shitty situation.
What the fuck? Oh my god. Oh my god, it's happening again. It's happening again. Oh jeez. Oh my god. That ship is glitching out like fuck. It's flying.
Spent my time there. I was very active. I was job hunting like fuck. And I applied at over 200 places, I think. I just kept applying and applying. I must have applied at almost every... if you go into Bath City Centre, like every shop that you see on the high street, every business you can see in Bath, I've applied there. Like everything. Everything you can fucking see. I've gone in, I've applied there. And out of all that, I only got... So it's like 200 places or more. I only got like 6 interviews total. And I only got 2 yeses to my interviews. And they happened at exactly the same time, so I had to choose.
Everyone's routing? Why are they routing towards us? Or like, wait, let's run away! Let's run away towards the enemy! That's a brilliant idea. This is ridiculous. Yep. Army up on the hill is completely fucked by vast numbers. Jesus Christ.
Ironically, what is left is very fertile. While everything is destroyed, only canyons and a strange, fertile ashen soil remain. The archangels who survived had lost everything and abandoned their home. But we saw lights on the archangels' destroyed planet recently. Someone is trying to plant crops down there. Who are you? What are you doing out here, in the destroyed lands of the archangels? He glanced back at the nervous creatures and gestured them to continue their work, which seemed to be either moving equipment or spraying the pools with something. I am Snook, a simple kerosene farmer, I assure you.
And it is fun to get a bunch of people in a server like this and just have a laugh and play around. Just mess around, it's fun. Take my favourite ship now. Behind helicopter, yes, the MI-24, I believe it's called. But it's the Hind, and it's heavier than the Apache, so it has different handling characteristics. Look how much firepower there is. Well, I've looked forward to doing this for a while, getting back in the Hind. I love peeping up, you know, peeping up at a, like, I know there's someone in one of these bunkers and I fly all this way just to find them. And then, just like, oh, see, I completely missed that time. Just like peeping up in the ground like that and then taking them out and then flying off. Down a valley or something.
As soon as Ogilvy saw me among the staring crowd on the edge of the pit, he called me to come down. and asked if I would mind going over to see Lord Hilton, the Lord of the Manor. The growing crowd, he said, was becoming a serious impediment to their excavations, especially the boys. They wanted a light railing put up, and help to keep people back. He told me that a faint stirring was occasionally still audible within the case, but that the workmen had failed to unscrew the top, as it afforded no grip to them. Weird.
Okay, let's drive in the little... Can you hear that? Funny little... Just random, could be anything Arabic music. Just Arabic sounding random drumming that could be anything. They should play Bara Bara from Black Hawk Down in the car. It'd be awesome.
Then, slowly, the hissing passed into humming, into a long, loud, droning noise. Slowly a humped shape rose out of the pit, and the ghost of a beam of light seemed to flicker out from it. Forthwith, flashes of actual flame, a bright glare leaping from one to another, sprang from the scattered group of men. It was as if some invisible jet impinged upon them and flashed into white flame. It was as if each man was suddenly and momentarily turned to fire. Then, by the light of their own destruction, I saw them staggering and falling, and their supporters turned to run. I stood, staring, not as yet realizing that this was death leaping from man to man in that little distant crowd.
Is that like a shotgun? It's pretty incredible. Basically, there's a huge village here that we're guarding as the Iraqis, and from across the water they come, the infidels, they come, the coalition, bunch of black helicopters come over the little sea there, I guess. On the map that you can disrupt, but it's not 100% clear where you meant to look at. What the fuck is going on? That's how it works, apparently. There's a high fuck. What just happened? Ah. Oh, I love these games. Can you do that in Battlefield 1?
In most people's minds, it started out as, this is the next Battlefield game. We don't know what the setting is. It wasn't so long ago that it was revealed as World War II, although you can hardly call it World War II from the trailer. It looks like some jungle sci-fi thing. Could it be a Korean War game? Could it be a new Vietnam game? Which would have suited the title of BFV. You got all these eras from history you could have brought up. And they just went for the easy option, World War II. But they didn't just go for that. I mean, that would have... That alone would have made a lot of players, not me in particular, would have pleased a lot of people. And a lot of people were like, yes, a World War II game. That's what I wanted. And then, of course, the trailers came out and they're like, ugh. A head rose over the arch, and the figure of a workman carrying a basket appeared. Beside him ran a little boy. He passed me, wishing me good night. I was minded to speak to him, but did not. Over the Maybury Arch a train, a billowing tumult of white violet smoke, and a long caterpillar of lighted windows, went flying south, clatter, clatter, clap, rap, and it had gone. A dim group of people talked in the gate of one of the houses in the pretty little row of gables that was called Oriental Terrace. What news from the common? Said I. There were two men and a woman at the gate. Eh? Said one of the men, turning. What news from the common? I said.
Ain't you just been there? Asked the men. People seem fair silly about the common, said the woman over the gate. What's it all about?
I've been waiting for you, Obi-Wan. We meet again, Anakin.
Halfway there, we have the upper hand. We have taken objective George.
At that time, firing was going on across the common, and it was said the first party of Martians were crawling slowly towards their second cylinder, under cover of a metal shield. Later, this shield staggered up on tripod legs and became the first of the fighting machines I had seen. The gun he drove had been unlimbered near Horsell in order to command the sandpits, and its arrival it was that had precipitated the action. As the limber gunners went to the rear, his horse trod down a rabbit hole and came down, throwing him into a depression of the ground. At the same moment, the gun exploded behind him. The ammunition blew up. There was fire all about him, and he found himself lying under a heap of charred dead men and dead horses.
Can you hear me?
Happy.
I'm going to be honest. I hate
speech.
Please remove any metallic items you're carrying, keys, loose change.
Holy shit!
I don't care how you fucking feel.
Back up! Stand back up!
I'm gonna have to go to jail. What we can do is just enjoy the little bit of time that we have left.
Hi! Run into the fire! Come on then, boy. I'm in fire. I thought I would take him with me. I didn't take him with me. I kind of fucked that up, didn't I?
Jump in the fire!
It's like humble opinions, Tim Morrison. All these people have such really good, like, speaking voices. Like, Chad, you don't understand. It's crispy. Well, I mean, I could. See, you just have to be like born to grow up to have that voice. Genetics or I don't know. Something. Oh, I'm gonna like massacre the entire world. Customer who came in just now. As a vegan, I still eat prawns. A prawn is a type of sea insect.
Vegans! I think you should know I am a vegan. Oh, meat is murder. Stop killing the little chickens. I think you should know I am a vegan. Oh, meat is murder. Please put down your big beef burger.
I come from Byfleet, he said. Man on a bicycle came through the place in the early morning and ran from door to door, warning us to come away. Then came soldiers. We went out to look, and there were clouds of smoke to the south. Nothing but smoke, and not a soul coming that way. Then we heard the guns at Chertsey, and folks coming from Weybridge. So I've locked up me house and come on. At the time, there was a strong feeling in the streets that the authorities were to blame for their incapacity to dispose of the invaders without all this inconvenience. About 8 o'clock, a noise of heavy firing was distinctly audible over the south of London.
Did not expect that to happen, to be fair.
Oh god, a flare just landed right next to me.
Almost flanked them. Shoots a lot of them. Throw grenade.
I don't have any.
Oh shit.
Get out of here. Get out of here. Wilsh blade in your face. Get out of here.
What are you doing?
I'm just peppering the roof because they won't do anything about me.
Oh, great.
It's kind of funny and I'm just annoying them.
That's great.
They're all dying from me. I think I've killed like four people. What are they doing? Thank you for the 7 kills. A customer came in. She was talking about getting her friends interested in some products. She said, I'll raise that at our next vegan meet. Vegan meat, how ironic.
Vegans!
The St. George's Hill men, however, were better led, or of a better metal. Hidden by a pine wood as they were, they seemed to have been quite unsuspected by the Martian nearest to them. They laid their guns as deliberately as if they had been on parade, and fired at about 1,000 yards range. The shells flashed all around him, and he was seen to advance a few paces, stagger, and go down. The Martian who had been overthrown crawled tediously out of his hood. A small brown figure, oddly suggestive from that distance, of a speck of blight, and apparently engaged in the repair of his support.
Come and meet the doctor.
But I haven't...
The people in town.
I haven't died
He's
yet.
He's beeping!
Okay, where's our house? I'm near a sewer. Is that our house?
That's not our house. Whose house? You don't live in a sewer.
Haha, Burton, LMR! Thank you! I've unlocked it! Well, I don't have the zoomy one, but I've got the trench.
Don't tell me that, I will
You
hate
shushing
you.
Me?
Yeah, I
How dare you shush me? I'll shush you. Shh!
No, you shush! Stop bragging about having the burden.
I'm not bragging.
Yes, you are.
No, I just said I had it.
Shut up. I don't know.
I did nothing wrong.
Yeah, you did. You unlocked it before. Oh, thank
you, Solars. Lul, he stepped in my fire.
Would you like to try a bottle of rock slime?
The captain lay off the Blackwater until 5 in the afternoon. Big iron upperworks rose out of this headlong structure, and from that twin funnels projected and spat up a smoking blast shot with fire. It was the torpedo ram Thunderchild, steaming headlong, coming to the rescue of the threatened shipping. Keeping his footing on the heavy deck by clutching the bulwarks, my brother looked past his charging leviathan at the Martians again, and he saw the three of them now close together and standing so far out to sea that their tripod supports were almost entirely submerged.
God, I don't care about all this business stuff. This isn't so much a game as a chore.
I used to spray wasps with the cleaning thing, and I think I inhaled that and I burned my throat.
Spraying wasps, like in your room, sort of thing? Or outdoors?
Yeah, in the kitchen.
Oh, okay.
Because they are swarming me whenever I cook.
Jeez, there must be... Maybe there's a nest near you or something.
Yeah,
outdoors.
Probably. My neighbor said it's in a tree, but we're not allowed to handle it because they're protected, apparently, in Germany. Why the fuck would you protect wasps?
Say again? They're protected? By who?
Yeah, by the... I don't know, whoever protects wasps.
Environmentalists. Yeah. Green Party people.
Idiots, I hope they get stung by bees until they... float like marshmallows.
Yeah, I'm kind of scared of wasps.
Yeah, me too.
Whenever we find one, a nest in our garden, it's like, what chemical methods can we What chemical warfare can we use on them?
It's really simple, actually. They die fast if you spray them with gasoline.
Gasoline? Jeez.
Yeah, with diesel. They die instantly.
I wouldn't have thought of doing that. We've been spraying them with like eucalyptus oil and stuff like that.
No, that shit doesn't work. I just bought some. How do you call it? Yeah, my grandfather used to do it.
Oh, did he?
At countryside, because at the countryside there are like the wasps.
Yeah.
And they used to make nests next to where he kept his fishing utensils.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah, and he just sprayed them with the gasoline and it was instant death.
Yeah, I wouldn't like being sprayed by gasoline in the face either, so I can see how that would work.
I got some peppermint oil, they don't care. They are so...
People come in our shop and ask for pepper. We sell that. People ask for peppermint essential oil to like scare off spiders, and also cats for some reason.
Yeah,
I don't know why. Cats and spiders. I don't get it.
Okay.
But
something.
Yeah, I don't know if it. I don't think it'd probably work on wasps. We had them in. We had like these. You get like mole hills. In England and Germany probably as well. And the wasps in one of my old houses made a nest in one of those.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we like smoked it out. I think
Dad
little fiery thing and put it down the hole.
Uh-huh.
I think it pacifies them, but it doesn't really get rid of them.
No.
There's your teammate. Oh my god! Get out of here!
Jesus, I should have killed you, shouldn't I?
Scale studies. So, basically scale studies is, it's kind of a fun lesson, but also a very, very depressing lesson once kids get to the end of it. And it would sort of focus on kids grasping scale of all varieties, and how colossal scale is, and how to get an internal, in your head, vision of the scale of things. Now what am I talking about? I'm talking about perceiving crowd sizes. What does 40 people look like? How many people can you know or get to know before you lose the ability to start losing connection with the people and forgetting people's names and forgetting who they are? And what does it look like when someone quotes a number, like a number of people? What does that crowd look like in real life? Especially when you're talking like battlefield statistics in history. Like, how many people were at this battle? Well, there was 100,000 people at this battle. How many people died in this tsunami? There was 300,000 people died in this tsunami. How many people is that when they're in front of me? Am I able to get a sense of that?
Thought I'd bring you up here.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's why they put their floodlight thing on. They have shutters on it, so they get the sunlight right. They point it, and then they flash it and do...
Yeah, it flashes.
Yeah.
Its motion was so swift, complex, and perfect that at first I did not see it as a machine, in spite of its metallic glitter.
Sorry? Cursing in Romanian.
Cursing in Romanian, are you?
Yeah.
What was that word then?
I just told him to go into his mother vagina.
Oh. Reverse birth to you, my friend.
Yeah.
Reverse birth to
we
you.
We have some weird
like,
fuck your mother, dead people.
We don't have one like that in England. Go back
yep.
into your mother's
we have
vagina.
I bet you don't.
So we're at Brentor Church.
Whippets or something. Oh, here come. High speed dogs. Is there a door? Oh, you can go in? Oh, you can actually... Ah! There's church bells.
There's a tower.
Oh, creepy. It's very creepy.
Repent, repent, oppressors of the poor and needy, the winepress of God. Then he would suddenly revert to the manner of the food I withheld from him, praying, begging, weeping, at last threatening.
It's not where they put the slaves when they feed them to the lion.
Oh look, there's a bit of a reservoir-y thing up here.
So it's running off.
Yeah, maybe it keeps going that way. Hidden obstructions exist beneath the waterline. Danger of death. Let's just have a little peek down here. That's real Betsy over there. I think it's kind of forced when you expect someone to do things for you all the time, and you ask them to do things for you all the time, unless it's something serious where you're in trouble and you need help. Yeah. But the other way round will keep the friendship going, where you will try and do something for your friend, and it's your choice. It's your choice to, it's my choice to do something for my friend to keep the friendship going.
Nice though.
I like the weird landscape, it's nice.
Boys, here we go, boys.
Oh, new boys. Oh, new.
Never in my dreams would I have guessed.
Like, oh, that's... So once you've heard it the first time... Hey! Mind me. Once you've heard it for the first time, you've spoiled it for yourself. And you hear it in every movie after that. Without thinking about it.
I can't remember what it sounds like, actually.
All these... The sort of people that lived in these houses, and all those damn little clerks that used to live down that way, they'd be no good. They haven't any spirit in them. No proud dreams and no proud lusts. And a man who hasn't one or the other, Lord, what is he but funk and precautions? They just used to skedaddle off to work. I've seen hundreds of them. Bit of breakfast in hand, running wild and shining to catch their little season ticket train, for fear they'd get dismissed if they didn't. Working at businesses, they were afraid to take the trouble to understand. Skedaddling back for fear they wouldn't be in time for dinner. Keeping indoors after dinner for fear of the back streets. And sleeping with the wives they married, not because they wanted them, but because they had a bit of money that they would make for safety in their one little miserable skedaddle through the world. Well, the Martians will just be a godsend to these. Nice roomy cages, fattening food, careful breeding, no worry. After a week or so chasing about the fields and lands on empty stomachs, they'll come and be caught cheerful. They'll be quite glad after a bit. They'll wonder what people did before there were Martians to take care of them. Gavrilo Princip and five other men were sent out to Sarajevo by the Black Hand as assassins one day to kill Archduke Franz Ferdinand, who was going to be the heir to the throne of the Empire of Austria-Hungary. Huge country back then, which contained some of the South Slavic regions needed by the Black Hand to unify. After botching the original assassination plan and thinking it a failure, and after hurried changes en route of Franz Ferdinand and his wife Sophie's vehicle, Gavrilo Princip was placed accidentally in a place where he could fulfill the mission. He assassinated the royal couple with a pistol on the Latin Bridge in Sarajevo.
Brat.
This is a nice little river. I like it.
You're liking?
I don't know if you're going to get up to the top, Dad.
Oh, it's wetter than I thought.
Not so much the stillness of death, it was the stillness of suspense, of expectation. It crept almost imperceptibly upon my senses. It was a sobbing alternation of two notes. Ula, 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 keeping on perpetually. When I passed streets that run northward, it grew in volume, and houses and buildings seemed to deaden and cut it off again. A dozen of them, stark and silent, and laid in a row, were the Martians.
Why can't we paint each other like Gary's mod or whatever?
Towards you.
That was an epic kill, Alexander.
I drifted, a demented man. I found myself in a house of kindly people, who had found me on the third day, wandering, weeping, and raving through the streets of St. John's Wood. They have told me that I was singing some insane doggerel about the last man left alive, hurrah, the last man left alive.
What? 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 What's? How? We need a different machine, don't we? We need some kind of...
I think so.
We need to build something special, because we can't smelt the aluminium, can we? So,
yep.
There must be a... Whoa! Come back, Tether. There must be a machine we can get. That does extra smelting. Yeah, that's probably what we're missing. To make iron, maybe.
Get on top of the mountain.
Okay, there are tethers all the way up to the top of the mountain now.
I tried studying Japanese. I only know to say, that's a window.
That's a window?
Yeah.
That's a very useful phrase you've got yourself there.
Yeah.
How do you say that then?
Arewa mado desu.
Oh. Not, that's a window.
No. That's okay. A window.
On your Japanese comment, do you know the word in English, defenestration?
Defenestration? No.
Yeah, I quite like that one. That is to throw someone out of a window.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's an interesting word.
Defenestrate someone is to throw them out of a window. It's a defenestration.
Awesome.
I'm gonna eat what? I'm gonna eat your friggin' beetroot.
Yeah, I got more food.
Now try swimming. Try swimming. That's a good trick. Oh, I'm above another one. They're all down below me. What the fuck? I'm gonna drop all my grenades.
No grenade, what?
Die! All of you. What do they think they're doing? They're gathering underneath me in a big swarm. I ask for reprieve. You're hitting the ground. Oh god, that fireball.
Yeah.
That's too low. It's coming in. Oh, I saw the fireball though. Right, this is level, off to the side. You might do something here, you might do something. Oh, it was so close, but no! It's too low, it's too low. It's carved into the ground by the looks of it.
What?
A big chunk is headed off upward.
A bit of it was way further away than what it is.
Oh no, there's...
Oh, I missed you.
We could take out my light panel? Nope, he went around the outside of it. Peace.
I can't see my parachutes working very well. Okay, I'm okay.
I think I went over. Did I go over? Must have passed by by now.
It's right where the nose would be in the smiley face.
What a douche!
You're carrying a tiny, tiny fish. Oh my god, look how small it is. We gonna eat that? That's hardly enough for anyone.
You're gonna eat it.
I'm gonna eat it. Look at this.
How big is this?
Oh my god! That's a massive fish. That's not gonna film the barbecue. I've got to let Remy out. You running with that fish looks hilarious. Going up Gertor. Jeff Wayne's third, I guess, album of War of the Worlds. Third big album, I guess. Anyway.
Now, look closely.
The cylinder hitting their house, the house that journalist and Nathaniel hide in. That sound effect is basically nothing in this. It's like... Like, oh, it's done. Oh, okay. An entire cylinder just landed on their freaking house, and there's nothing. In the original musical, it's like, clang, 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 clang. It's like really like dramatic. Like they've been landed on by a fucking meteor. Like, you'd hear something. I imagine, you would hear something.